In this video, we will provision EKS cluster and EC2 node group, and then deploy NGX Docker image as a service in the cluster. All steps are using the AWS Management Console without installing anything on your local box. Let's start. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lian Duan, and I have developed for over 20 years, specializing in DevOps and cloud security. Before we dive into the hands-on demo, ensure you have an AWS account, and the account can access the AWS Management Console. The root account is used in my demo. If you use different AWS account, please make sure your account has all need permissions. The AWS EKS master role and EC2 workgroup role were created, and the two roles will be applied in the cluster creating process. Only Amazon EKS cluster policy is used by AWS EKS master role. The EKS work node group role has three policies: Amazon EC2 container registry read only, Amazon EKS CI policy, Amazon EKS work node policy. If you'd like to see the more detail of the two roles, there is my video, AWS EKS roles. In my hands-on demo, we'll create an EKS cluster and then touch an EC2 node group of the cluster. After the cluster is running, a web app will deploy it. We should see the index page with a load balance address. Open the Firefox and log into the AWS console. Log in as a root account. Input the password. Go next. In services area, search EKS. Select Electrical Kubernetes Service. First part, create an EKS cluster. Click button Add Cluster. Select Create. Cluster name EKS Demo. Use the latest available version 1.28. Cluster service role is EKS Cluster Admin. The role only has one policy, Amazon EKS Cluster Policy. Move a little bit down. Cluster authentication mode uses default one, EKS API, and config map. Cluster authentication is on the pod level. When a pod uses a specified service account, it automatically links the associated IAM role. Move to the bottom, add a tag. Key is demo, value is EKS. The tags will help us easily select resources. Go to next page. VPC uses default one. Only keep two subnets in the selection to match the minimum request by EKS. Move a little bit down. Cluster endpoint access use public and private for our demo. During the production environment, private is select and limited for a few people. Go to next page. Move to the bottom. The login part is turned off as default. Click next. Select for add-ons. Move to next page. Add-on version is use default one. I'll demo how to upgrade add-on version to the latest in the feature video. Go to latest step. Review all the configuration we select. Create the cluster. Back to the cluster list page. You see the EKS demo cluster is creating now. It will take from 10 to 20 minutes. After the cluster is active, next part is creating EC2 node group. Click cluster name. Go to the computer tab. Move a little bit down. Today, we are focused on the EC2 node group. I'll create a video for how to add ECS Fargate into EKS cluster. Click add node group. Group name is EKS node group. The EC2 work group role has three policies. As I mentioned before, Amazon EC2 container registry read-only, Amazon EKS CI policy, and Amazon EKS work node policy. Move a little bit down. Add Kubernetes labels. Demo EKS. Add one more label. Demo EKS node group. The labels can be used to pod selection. Add a tag. Demo EKS node group. Go to next page. Instance type, select T3 small. The maximum number of IP addresses on an EC2 instance affects the number of pods which one can be scheduled on the instance. In Kubernetes, each pod has assigned unique IP address. Therefore, the total number of pods that can be run on EC2 instance is constrained by the available IP address. As an example, for T3 small instance, the max pod are 11. The calculation is 3 multiplication 3 and plus 2. The result is 11 pods. Open the page to see the formula detail. Also, in the line 39 has the alt instance IP address detail information. We can open it to see it. Search t3.small. The information same as the drop-down list. By the way, the t4g.small instance type is only available on the command line. Please remember, the t4g.small instance has 750 hours per month for free. Back to the creation page. Move to the bottom. Note group scaling configuration will put this all three selections are one. Click Next. Go to next page. Reveal our selection. Everything looks good. Create. Back to the cluster page. Go to the computer type again. You'll see the node group is creating. Usually it takes 10 minutes. The creating time depends on your region and the instance type. The EC2 group status is active now. While using the AWS Cloud Shell to deploy an NGX Docker image as service on the cluster and verify it. Open the Cloud Shell. It's loading. Our current region is US East 1. Run the command AWS STS get caller identity. STS means security token service. This command provides information about the AWS identity to ensure your current account has the right permissions. Enter. There is our result, various root account. While install the kubectl command in the Cloud Shell, open the official doc to find right version. Our Kubernetes cluster is on the 1.28. Let me find the matched kubectl version. Move a little bit down. Select Linux AMD64 type. Option is for the Kubernetes cluster version 1.28. Copy the command. Back to the Cloud Shell. Paste. Download completed. Give the execute permission for the kubectl. Enter. Run command kubectl version space -- client. The command displays the installed Kubernetes client version. Version is 1.28.1. This step ensures that the correct version of kubectl is installed for interacting with EKS cluster. Next, update the kubeconfig for EKS cluster. Command is AWS EKS update kubeconfig. Region is US East 1. US East 1 means North Virginia. Cluster name is EKS demo. Enter. The command configure kubectl to communicate with the specified EKS cluster. It updated the kubeconfig file with the necessary cluster information. Next command, use kubectl apply -f with a YAML file to deploy NGX Docker image to the EKS cluster. Enter. Open new tab to see the deployment detail. This is a simple NGX deployment file. The Docker image from Elastic Container Registry. Port number is 80. Back to the Cloud Shell. Deployment successfully. Clear up the screen. Next step, run the command expose the NGX deployment as a load balance service. It creates a service type of load balancer. Make the application accessible from internet. Enter. We use the kubectl get service plus service name to retrieve the load balance address. Copy the external IP and open new tab to access it. The creation in process take time. The index page is coming. Congratulations, you're on the EKS world. Our demo successfully. To save your money, do not forget, clean up all EKS resources. Close the Cloud Shell. We'll delete node group first, and then delete cluster. Select node group, delete. put the name, delete. The delete also takes some time. This is all for today's video. Thank you for watching and see you in the next time.